Hey everybody, Scott Spreitzer here, DocSports.com, and welcome to the update for Sunday, January 19th, 2020. Free pick in the NFL coming up, a prop on this report. Hey, first a quick note, if you're not yet a member at DocSports.com, give it a trial run. $60 free account to be used on any of my daily packages or anybody else at DocSports.com. And all you got to do to get that free $60 account, click on the link in the description box below this video. It's as simple as that. Free $60 account. And again, that's a great way to give DocSports.com a trial run if you're not yet a member. All right, again, the free pick in just a moment. Wanted to clean up what happened yesterday. I had a losing day of college basketball. Listen, the good news is that with our last 45 college basketball sides, we are on a 61% run that goes back to December. The bad news is that we lost yesterday. We were that close to a winning day. With NC State, if they cover, we make a couple of units, but they lost, and so we have a bad day in college basketball, a rare bad day. And basically, we saw that game. They were laying 6.5, 7 points, up by 19 in the second half, still up by 9 with about 30 seconds to go. They had the ball, thinking they're going to get fouled, got a chance to go up 10 or 11. Instead, they commit a 10-second violation. They turn the ball over. You had a couple of fouls in the mix by NC State in the final 30 seconds, and then you had a missed back end of a pair of free throws, 8 or 9 seconds left to go, and then a missed front end of a 1-1 with about 4 seconds to go. I had turned it off by then, but I have buddies who are also at NC State who told me about the last front end of the 1-1. So they win by 6, laying 6.5 to 7. That was the difference maker for us. You know me, I don't come out here and like to whine a lot, but that was certainly one of those SVP bad beats, no doubt about it. And by the way, I had no action on the Stanford-USC game, but if you had Stanford or you know anybody who did, keep them away from sharp objects. That might have been the worst beat of the entire college basketball season. On the flip side, if you had USC, that was your best win you've had all year, maybe in your lifetime. But those were a couple of games that we were watching. Again, I had nothing on Stanford-USC, but I did have a difference maker on NC State, which came up a point and a half short. All right, real quickly, on Sunday, I've got 2 NFL plays available right now, including a big 7-star play aside in Sunday's NFL. They are available at DocSports.com. You can grab them right now with that free $60 account, or if you're already a member, go over and check it out. Go to my handicappers homepage and see if it's for you. We've hit almost 59% with our football plays over the past now 13 weeks as we head into Sunday, over a 3-month run of hitting almost 59% against the spread. I will be in college basketball action, got a couple of plays, one for sure, maybe two, that will be posted by 11:30 a.m. Eastern, 8:30 a.m. Pacific time. NBA and NHL, those are at 1 p.m. Eastern, 10 a.m. Pacific. I do have one play in the NBA for Sunday, by the way. Even though there's only 2 games, we do have one play, so check that out. Off the 30-plus point win with Detroit, we look to sweep the weekend in the NBA. All right, let's get to the free pick. Yesterday, we gave you a prop. It was Kelce over in receiving yardage for Kansas City. Today, we're going to turn to the other game, the NFC Championship, the battle between Green Bay and San Francisco. Shop around for this. I've seen this on Saturday morning, the under 35.5 receiving yards, by the way, on Alan Lazard, wide receiver for the Packers. I've seen this as high as 35.5 with the under. You got to lay a little bit of juice with that. I've seen it 5 yards lower than that. So shop around. But we don't think he's going to come up with 20 yards receiving in this game, and here's why. Last week, Alan Lazard had the ankle injury. He kept missing a lot of game time in that contest for the Packers. He's expected to play in this game by all indications, but he's not yet 100% healthy. And of course, you got to go up against those Niners corners and safeties who are healthy and are going to make life tough on him. Now, I told you before, you want to jump on props that can take place whether you're right or wrong on the side or the total, whatever your main bet happens to be. This is one of those. Alan Lazard under receiving yards. And again, you can find it as high as 35.5 at last check. Play him under, shop around for the best number. But again, even if it's down to 25.5 or the high 20s, we still like him under the total. And that's our prop play on the NFC game for Sunday's card. Again, go check out all my plays on Sunday. College basketball, 11:30 a.m. Eastern. And again, my NFL 2-0 card is available right now at DocSports.com, led by that 7-star play. If you like the videos, click on the thumbs up button. Be sure to subscribe. We got to get back in the win column here on the free pick report, after a losing day yesterday. If you have yet to subscribe, be sure to do so. We do appreciate those who have done so thus far. I'm Scott Spreitzer, DocSports.com. Let's put Sunday in the win column, and I will be back here Monday, 5 a.m. Eastern, 2 a.m. Pacific.